feel any better?
Not at all.
Well, at least it hasn't upset anyone.
Hey, guys, have you seen my parents? They were coming in today to see Miss Simeon.
No?
Never mind. So the symptoms are a weird empty sensation in my stomach, a feeling of lightheadedness, and an unusual amount of saliva in my mouth when I think of food. I checked on the internet, and apparently it might be something called the G-virus, which can only be cured by cutting off the infected part or the removal of the brain.
I'm gonna prescribe 2 weeks off and a couple of heavy sedatives a day for 6 weeks.
Thank you.
No, that's for me. What you just described is called being hungry. Now, for the last time, please get out of my office so I can curl up under my desk and revise my career choices.
Whip! Save yourself! There's been a poisonous chemical spill! Get to the quarantine room!
Kinda looks like soda.
No! It's a lethal cocktail of chemicals that will completely destroy your metabolism, deforming your body until your butt crack reaches your shoulder blades!
Yeah, that's soda. Gumball, you're such a hypochondriac.
No! The quarantine room is right there!
Germs on an average door handle than there are in a toilet seat.
Well, if that's the case, why don't we all open doors with our butts? Almost got it.
Darwin, what are you doing?
Just proving a point.
Principal Brown, Darwin is being recklessly unhygienic, and it's giving me ulcers. See?
Oh my gosh, your hand, it's covered in germs. Look.
There.
Diploma, the Royal College of Ducks? Because you're a certified quack! You haven't run a blood test, taken a temperature, or even an x-ray!
He's fine. He just needs to walk it off.
I'm talking about me! I've been in contact with these germ bags all day! I can feel myself getting ill.
Like Monday, when you thought the foam in your mouth was rabies, only to discover it was toothpaste? Or Tuesday, when you thought you broke your leg, even though you don't have any bones? Or yesterday, when you thought you'd gone deaf because nobody had spoken to you for 5 minutes?
I'd like to discuss appropriate school attire. So, where were we?
Yes! Why isn't it working?
Would you help me make her fall in love with Darwin?
Well, it depends. Who's the her in this conversation?
Terry! Darwin's into Terry.
Oh, really? I see.
I know! Weird, right? I thought he was into you, but nope, it's definitely Terry. There's photographic evidence if you want to see it. Look, look, see? It's her. It's Terry. Look at it. Can you see? Look, 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 look. You're not looking.
Oh, why don't you go clean your own hand, you clean freak?
Watch it now, you disgusting biohazard.
Man, for a paper girl, she's surprisingly strong.
I think it's more like you're surprisingly weak.
I don't want to wash it.
I had a high five from Penny 3 months ago and refused to wash it since.
Don't tell me you haven't showered in 90 days.
Of course I've showered. I'm not an art student. I just wrap my hand in swimming trunks to keep it dry.
Ask him how often he washes those.
You don't wash swimming trunks. They clean themselves when you swim. Right?
Ew!
Is she right?
What she is a pain in the neck who makes my job a nightmare.
If you have a pain in the neck, you should really consult a medical professional. Because your vertebrae may have slipped out of alignment, which could be a sign of something more serious.
Have a nice day.
Terry invited you to an event?
Your wedding?
Attending.
You want to clean up the alien slime on your laser gun? You could get sick from that.
I always carry my intergalactic antibacterial gel in case I need to interfere with people's lives.
I'm right here, you know.
What is that?
That's my mom. This is her website. She's a doctor.
Oh. Oh my gosh, what is that?
That is what happens to a finger if you don't disinfect a cut.
It looks like a purple foot covered in mayo.
A crime of passion?
She's too good not to be shared.
Evil germs are out to get us.
The germs are fine, man. They're part of life. That's Mother Nature trying to make you stronger.
Oh, really? You do know that the keyboard you just used has more germs on it than a toilet seat?
You're not quite the same as when we met.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that means there's more of you to love.
Happy birthday to you!
Happy birthday,
dear family!
Uncle Brian?
Attention-seeking itis. Dr. Darwin, is there a cure?
Yes, getting a life.
Ow! I just needed a hair sample.
Let me guess. You found a deadly virus previously unknown to science, and it's coming after us.
Yes, exactly.
Terry, meet your future father-in-law.
I'm sorry. Please don't judge me.
It wasn't hygienic, but I guess you cleaned it.
Not for that. For this.
Can I call him Dad? Could you at least look at it?
All right, whatever. What the pucks? Dude, she's right. There's a virus. And he's making rude gestures at me with those little tentacles.
Let me look. It's mutated and gone airborne!
Give me that!
Dinosaurs and princesses. Mm. And he's your uncle.
Yeah, so?
Marry me!
Called it.
Guess I owe you 20 bucks.
Okay, I get it. I'm moving too fast. I meant adopt me.
What?
Date! Should we date first?
You mean you want to be friends?
Best friends!
Okay.
The rest will follow naturally.
What? What's wrong?
Goes where?
This one goes there!
Where?
Ow!
Who brought the paper towels?
Run.
I can't!
Me neither! Hold on!
Sound great.
Hold on a second.
That's nothing. Because tattoos are forbidden, he made Terry erase her face.
How is she holding up?
Well, she tried to answer the phone, but Hopun then got detention for having a piercing.
Well, at least she finds comfort in feeding the science lab lizard.
Which virus do you think it is?
Let's read the symptoms.
Oh, what's the point? We'll never know which virus it is if it's always mutating. They're the worst. They always find a way to get you.
Then we need to fight fire with fire!
What are you doing?
Trying to mutate!
An email for free online medication without prescription!
Virus detected.
Dude, that sounds like a cow on anesthetics.
It's not that I'm not supportive, but they're kind of a train wreck. That, like, a truck crashed into and then the whole thing sunk into a lake and managed to catch fire and exploded.
Go, Elmer, go! My tail comb!
All right, I guess they didn't explode, but you have to admit that was...
Initiating virus protection protocol.
Maybe it's just rebooting. Did you see that?
help over here!
Try to turn it off and on!
Brings us to a lonely young girl called Terry. She lived her life in the safety zone, but there's no medication for falling head over heels in love. Alan rushed over. Did it hurt? Alan said, the gentle light glistening on his chiseled features. Not as much as all these years of yearning for you, she said, her heart in her mouth. Without further ado, they kissed, their lips crashing into each other, forever oblivious to the world around them.
Let's get out of here while he's still talking. Huh? Get down! It's a multi-changer! How did he get into the stereo?
He's mutated and infected the entire electrical system!
Terry, are you okay? She's not answering.
I think it's for the best, because if she tried to talk, she'd sound like...
My dad is rich in vitamin B6 and potassium. He's also a good source of fiber.
Well, my dad can beat rock. I'm so happy. They've got so much in common. They both float. They... Actually, that's about it. She's still better for him than Carmen, though.
I shouldn't have made fun of you.
At least she doesn't need to worry about germs anymore.
Watch out! Ah! No! Behind you!
No!
You guys,